surging demand for electric vehicles and solar energy is proving to be a double boon for low-profile Malaysian entrepreneur Tan Engki, co-founder and CEO of Penang-based Greytech Technology. The company, which makes industrial automation equipment for a variety of different manufacturers, saw its shares jump 330% in the past year, propelling Tan into the billionaires club with a net worth of just over $1 billion. Renewable energy and electric vehicles are hot now, says Tan, 50, who established the business in 1997 with his school buddy Corleen Heng, who now serves as Greytech's COO. They have boosted our profitability. Sales for the 9 months ended September 30, 2020 were up 17% to 184.78 million ringgit, $44.44 million, while net profit jumped 64% to 59.338 million ringgit, $14.27. Greytech makes automated equipment for production lines for a host of manufacturers, from medical device makers to renewable energy producers to semiconductor companies. The company, which gets more than 50% of its business from international markets, primarily the US, has a list of marquee clients including Lordstown Motors, a manufacturer of electric pickup trucks in Ohio, and Arizona-headquartered First Solar, which makes solar energy systems. Greytech's more notable products include a robotic hand for placing solar modules in a production line, equipment for handling solar wafers on a production line, and an automated measuring device for smartphones. As it migrated from making single automation equipment to producing entire production lines, and as it won more orders from clients like Panasonic and First Solar, the company's annual revenue and net profit rose tenfold between 2015 and 2019, the year when Tan decided to list Greytech on the Kuala Lumpur Stock Exchange. In October, Kuala Lumpur's Public Investment Bank projected that Greytech's revenue was poised to grow at a compounded rate of 47.5% over the next 3 years. Greytech is well positioned to capture the growth in the solar photovoltaic segment through its indirect exposure via First Solar, by supplying more production lines to First Solar, wrote Chua Su Lee, an analyst at the bank, who authored the October research report. Meanwhile, Tan, who is often referred to as EK, is taking his newly acquired billionaire status in stride. "I never had dreams of becoming a billionaire," he says. "I did not expect this at all. I have a simple life. I come to the office, do my job, and I go home. Nothing changes because of this." Tan grew up in Penang in what he describes as a poor family, the only son among four children. His father, who was a cab driver, died when Tan was just 13, forcing him to take on more responsibilities at a young age. At 16, he was working part-time after school at a bakery. Tan went on to earn a certificate in mechanical engineering in 1991, and began working as a production planner for a precision tooling company.